Krishna, to you, to the data center.
That's right. Talking about constituencies and looking at constituencies, let's get the latest leads from our World is One Wion election data center. That's going to come up any moment right now. There you go. It started getting multicolored, as we've been telling you. These are the five states. These are the number of seats that are there. And wherever, whichever party is winning, it turns into particular colors. Here, the light blue is Congress. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of them. In Madhya Pradesh, you have Shivraj Singh Chauhan, the incumbent chief minister, from 156. He's from 156 over here. And that's happening, 156, and he's contesting from there. Arun Yadav from the Congress party is contesting against him in 156, which is Budni, the seat called Budni. And you have Gopal Bhargava, the incumbent minister from BJP, in 39, Rehali. And you have Suresh Pachauri, Congress party, 141, in Bhojpur, right over here. So this is Madhya Pradesh, this is Rajasthan. Lot of light pink here in Rajasthan. Interesting. The exit polls were talking about this. And then you see Telangana Rashtra Samiti, lots of pink already. What is the time? Barely an hour into counting. So much pink. Telangana Rashtra Samiti leading the way in Telangana. Chhattisgarh, here, it's a good fight over here. Three blue ones, that's Congress party in constituencies 79, 80 and 81. And you have 85, 86, 87, that's going to the BJP. 37, 20, BJP, you know, ahead by a whisker in Chhattisgarh. And then you go to Mizoram, the Mizoram National Front, that's red in color here. 1, 2, 3. And in the Congress party, 1 and 2. That's the status. These are live updates that we're getting to you. These are automated updates. The Wion Election Data Center over here is all about automated updates. Nobody is punching in these numbers. These are the latest leads. And Kartikeya, look at Madhya Pradesh, look at Rajasthan, look at Chhattisgarh. You have Congress with a clear lead in Rajasthan right now and pretty neck to neck in the other two states.
You know, so the Krishna, the bottom line is that the fight is neck to neck. I think you are making a very relevant point, Krishna, here, which is that people thought the margin is going to be big. And Krishna, you are pointing out in Rajasthan, the margin is not big. Is it because of the fact that, you know, Congress was not able to, Francis, I'll come to you on this, they were not able to manage the rebels, you know. People said the rebels who were fighting in areas dominated by Ashok Gehlot, they melted away. But the Congress rebels in Sachin Pilot dominated areas stayed put. Is it because of that faction fighting?
The question, yes. You know what, we should throw it to the gentlemen who've come over here. What do you gentlemen think? Because this is good enough leads, ladies and gentlemen, to start making up our opinions. This is a good time to, if you look at this board over here, pink and light blue, the saffron and light blue are in almost equal numbers in two of the biggest states, Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan, and so in Chhattisgarh. Telangana seems like a lost cause over here for both the BJP and the Congress party, and Congress still in with a chance in Mizoram. If I were to take it to Mr. Anderson, you were telling us about in Rajasthan how in the last, you know, the run-up to the polling day, you had the RSS, giving a major backing to the BJP. Do you think that is reflecting in these numbers?
We don't know because we don't know what the actual vote is. You have to, and number 47, which you have going to the Congress, was it a division of 100 votes or was it a division of 10,000? That makes a difference. And we're not going to be able to make any judgment until you know that.
That's a very good call, Kartikeya. Extremely cautious.
Absolutely, because, you know, first I'll go to Daniel, because, you know, Rajasthan is something which the Congress said that they were going to sweep. Yes, Congress has done extremely well. Yes, they are leading. But the BJP is not far behind, Daniel. Why has that happened?
In the last 3 weeks, the BJP, the RSS put its strength behind the organization. They're trying to cut losses. They tried to salvage the situation so well that they wanted to recover and not allow that state to slip out of their hands. We really don't know how they will perform. But if one has to really guess, I don't think they are losing as badly as it would have been predicted. They should close at 50, 60 seats and the Congress at 110, 120. But what's surprising that coming from Rajasthan is the fact that the others, the independents, we thought that there'll be many independents. Yesterday we were seeing news that the Congress and the BJP are in touch with independent candidates. It's not happening as it had appeared.
So these are the live shots from counting centers. Now we'll go state by state. These are the shots which are coming from counting center. And let us go back to a state which we have ignored. You know, we have been focused on Madhya Pradesh. Yes, absolutely. We have focused on Chhattisgarh. Let's talk about Telangana a bit. You know, why has why has Chandrasekhar Rao done well when there were charges of, you know, crony capitalism, dynasty? People say, and the whole joke in Telangana was one family, one ticket, and then, you know, the tirade against the Chandrasekhar Rao was one family and all the tickets, you know, all the seats. Why has he been able to consolidate so much?
I think, if I may say so, the trends that are coming in from other media houses, 81 out of 119 with a target of 60 in Telangana, and TRS already is ahead in 58, so it's almost in their pocket. And it seems to me that this is the reward for creating the state. And the family, even though, you know, KCR is a family-run show and TRS, the family seems to have served the interests of the people of Telangana, which is actually, sadly speaking, a form of parochialism, the son of the soil and so forth.
You know, this brings me, I'll come to Dr. Anderson. This, you finish your point, Daniel, first.
No, like, if we really give a simple analogy, that in Madhya Pradesh, in Rajasthan, the Congress gave a face, the Moses, to take these people out to a promised land. There was no campaign that was in the state government. Was the state in Rajasthan was a faceless campaign for the Congress. Who knows Uttam Reddy? What are his credentials? What was his plans? What are his programs?
Telangana.
You know, in Telangana, it was a faceless campaign in that sense. And hence, I think it has dented the Congress prospects.
Okay, I'll bring a larger national question, you know, because this is something which cuts across states. Do those chief ministers or those politicians work who primarily focus on those schemes which directly reach the poor, you know, targeted delivery? You look at the former chief minister of Tamil Nadu, J. Jayalalitha, Amma canteens, Amma kitchen, Amma water, you know, brand, food, and basics directly to the poor. The second
Don't
example is
TV.
Chandrasekhar Rao, most of the policies were very rural oriented and directed to a segment. And even the former chief minister, the late chief minister, YSR Reddy, his local ambulance program was a runaway success. So this brings me to Narendra Modi. Has he shifted his constituency from middle class to very poor? Has that shift happened?
No. As I said, you know, these policies that benefit the poor, you know, they're short terms. They're meant for electoral purpose. They're not meant to raise India at a national level. I think Mr. Modi tried to raise India at a national level, and that is very praiseworthy. You know, the Telangana chief minister, you know, has done so many programs, you know, which cost a lot of money to the state, you know, and which are only for electoral purpose. You know, in my opinion, this is wrong. But maybe that's
okay,
why he's winning.
Before I come to both of you.